Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Long time no see. It's been a while since I last uploaded a video, and I gotta apologize to you guys because I promised myself that I would upload at least daily, at most once every 2 days. That's the longest I'll go without uploading a video, but yeah, it's been a while. So usually I edit all the videos myself. I do have an editor on the side, but that's my brother, and my brother likes the video editing space. He actually wants to go into it and study it in school, so I throw him a bone. I throw him a project or two. I pay him for it, of course, but he's not my full-time editor. He's got other things going on, and I don't want to pull him away from that stuff in order to be able to edit my weird videos. So for the most part, all the videos that come up on this channel are edited by me, so it can be pretty exhausting. So this week I kind of took a break from doing that stuff. I consciously made a decision to step back, stream only, because I really like streaming, and yeah, just not upload anything. But that changes now, of course. I'm back to making videos, so you'll expect some more. But that's not what I came here to talk about, okay? For those of you who know what has been going on in the past 24 hours, it's been kind of crazy, and I kind of wanted to shed some light on it and give my thoughts. And don't lie, most of you are here because of this stuff. So recently, I actually made a promise to my Twitch chat that if we got 1,500 subscribers on Twitch, then we would do a cosplay stream. Now recently, Corone-san, which is a VTuber that I very much like, had a new outfit revealed that looked very similar to what I wore one time on stream, with like a pink bow and it was a Demon Slayer like gi, or what are those called again? Kimono, something like that. Anyways, I did that, and it kind of sparked a little bit of memeage in my community, and it was a lot of fun until Corone-san actually came out with a new outfit, and one of those variants of that outfit had the pink bow. So a lot of people made some correlations to myself and Corone. It was really funny. It was memey and stuff. So I decided, you know what? If we get our 1,500 subs and I do a cosplay, I'll do a cosplay of Corone's new outfit with the pink bow and everything like that. Long story short, we met the goal. I got 1,500 subs, and I promised the stream I will cosplay Corone. And I will cosplay as Corone. Ready? Get it? I swear, man, these freaking names for these VTubers, they're too good, like, and they correlate too much with my name, right? Coco, Corone, it's just, I don't know. So I got to work. I got my girlfriend involved. She is really big into making clothes and stuff, and she's got some pretty nifty hobbies that make this a reality, such as, you know, fabric, doing stuff with fabric, I don't know, sewing, stitching, knitting, stuff like that. We were deciding if we wanted to go with a little bit of jank and cheap, or if we wanted to go all out and actually try to replicate it to a T. And I think it came out pretty good. She did some crazy stuff with the actual designs of the T-shirt. Like, I wore a tank top, essentially, and had the designs of the fingers and the dogs. It came out looking pretty good, actually. And of course, I wore the pink bow that I originally wore when this whole shenanigan started. I got the sleeves. We got the trim cuts with the fur. We got the shorts, I got the socks, I got a lot of things, and lo and behold, it was time for the actual stream to happen, and it went really well. It was the first time I ever cosplayed something as extensive as that. I did a little bit of like a dress-up as Ganryu with the Halloween stream last year, with playing Tekken and stuff, and if you guys were there for that, it was awesome. I have a video up for that as well. My girlfriend dressed up as Julia, and if you know that whole lore with Ganryu and Julia, you know how appropriate it was for us to do that, to be honest. It was a lot of fun. But as extensive as this, cosplaying Corone, a Hololive member, it was the first time I've ever done anything like that. I'm not gonna lie, it was a huge step out of my comfort zone, but as soon as I got into it, I was just having fun. The stream really liked it. Everybody popped off. We watched Corone clips. We were gonna play Banjo-Kazooie, but then the chat convinced me to do other things, like, for example, we do like a punishment game. Like, if they can make me laugh too through text-to-speech, then I get to karaoke on stream. And I've never, ever karaoke'd in my entire life. I'm not kidding you when I say that. I have not karaoke'd ever. And the reason why is because I don't like it. I don't like karaoke. I get too shy. So I never did it. Ever, ever, ever. Never been invited to it. And if I did, I always declined. I never liked it. So I lost. Shocker. And I performed 24 Hour Cinderella by Majima from Yakuza 0. So it was the first time I've ever cosplayed something as extensive as that. And it's the first time I ever karaoke'd in my life. Anyways, that was a lot of fun. I ended the stream. I was happy with it. Quite a few people showed up, and it was great. You know, it was a lot of fun. Did it for the chat. And if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be doing that. So I did it for them, essentially. I hope that the chat had a good time, and that's that. But what happened afterwards was something that I did not expect to happen. Number one, somebody, one of my viewers, actually posted on the Hololive Reddit my cosplay, and it blew up. My cosplay actually blew up on the Hololive Reddit, which was extremely great. I've been on the Hololive Reddit many, many times. I posted there many, many times. And of course, it's a lot of fun. The community there is really cool. People like Hololive there, and I do too. So it's great that my cosplay kind of blew up in the Hololive Reddit and such. Two, people were tagging Korone, which I was kind of expecting, but at the same time, not to that extent. People were to the point where she noticed, finally. Somebody in the JP Twitterverse posted the Reddit Hololive post that somebody, one of my viewers, did, and she noticed it, and she basically liked it, and to the point where I replied to her. And she replied back to me, and it was a lot of fun. I was not expecting Corona to actually see the cosplay and her liking it. So that was pretty awesome. By the way, we're not done yet. The third thing, the thing I was not expecting, okay? Fubuki. Now, Fubuki has commented on my stuff before. She actually watched the Hachima cooking stuff, and she liked it. She thought it was really funny, et cetera, et cetera. I made a video about it. Well, she's back. And she commented on the Korone cosplay as well. And she said, wow. So the friend actually liked the cosplay as well. I was not expecting Fubuki to also comment on the cosplay. That was pretty funny. So Korone, Fubuki, the Reddit, everybody was just giving big props, congratulating me, I guess. I don't know what's to congratulate about, really. People were, you know, commemorating the fact that I did this for the first time, which I was really, really grateful for. Thank you so much for the kind comments. Like I said, it's the first time I extensively cosplayed something like this, and it was a lot of fun. So the next thing I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be reading comments from the Reddit. There's a lot of really cool comments out there, and I decided, you know what, maybe I should do this for a video. I thought it'd be a cool idea for me to read and get some thoughts out there and possibly even answer some questions if there are any. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. All right, so here's the Reddit post. Wow, 10K upvotes. Sheesh. That's a lot of upvotes. So I'm going to be handpicking these. Of course, I'm going to be filtering some of them out. And I wanted to see which ones those the most interesting ones for me to answer or to react to. So let's see these. Still remember how he was watching Hachima while she was watching him, watching her cooking the tarantula. Yeah, a lot of people tend to really like that interaction. And that one caught me out of left field. I did not know that she was going to do any of that, like watching my videos, at least the translated videos. And it turned into like a reactionception. And she was cooking the tarantula and she was watching my videos while doing it. It was kind of, it was very surreal and it was really cool. Corona saw it, and looking at the replies, JP Bros seemed to like him as well. I mean, he's very likable from what I've seen from his streams. Hey, thank you. I appreciate that. That's really nice of you to say. Aside from the pseudo collab with Coco and Hachima, there are Japanese translators that clip him and his reaction, some of which are 200K in views. I'm sure it's a lot more now though. Yeah, that is 100% correct. So there is this clipper or this translator called Mino. Shout outs to Mino-san. He likes to go ahead and look at specific content creators and translate them over to the Japanese audience. And I've happened to be one of those people. And I looked at the most popular video on his channel. And the most popular video on his channel is a video of me reacting to Utako naming an Animal Crossing island after male genitalia. And that video is almost at 1 million views. It's kind of nutty. And there's been other clips as well, like the Hachima cooking videos and other things that he likes to translate as well. And he likes to do other content creators. He hasn't really been uploading too much, but much respect to Mino-san. What a Chad. I think you mean simp. You mean chimp? Return to monkey. Apes together strong. You know, keep up the good work. Just ape together strong. I was there, Nags, hands up. Shout out to Nags. Ah, the great coefficient, the hip connoisseur. Here is a man who went down the rabbit hole and never came back since then. I still remember how he was in awe watching Kaicho's hip movements while she was dancing in her 3D debut. He then proceeded giving a speech about the greatness of hips. Not long after that, Ko was presented by his viewers to Akiro-sama's pro hip techniques. He ascended, and since then, went even further down into the rabbit hole. Hips never lie. Hips will lead to the truth. Thus has spoken the hip man. Edit, fix the typo. thanks. And interesting speech you got going on there. Yeah, the only thing I can really comment on this is the fact that once, you know, Kaicho actually went into her 3D debut and she kind of featured me in her Asakoko thing, my life has pretty much changed. YouTuber life has pretty much turned upside down. I can't thank her enough for that. Ko and Nags are like the best streamers with VTuber fandom type of streamers. Nags has an amazing series where he has been discovering the gals one by one, and his community's really nice. And Ko is just an enthusiastic bro with an also great community. Then there's 8-Bit Drummer, who played Blue Rose 7 hours after the music video release, among other Suisei songs he played after release. I actually have looked into 8-Bit Drummer, and he's cool. He actually does like covers of the VTuber songs, and not just VTuber songs, just any song in video games or in anime or anything like that, and he covers them with drums. It's really, really cool. You probably have seen him. So I was looking into him, and he seems like a cool dude. Oh no, he's hot. All right, I don't know about that, but I appreciate the SpongeBob reference. I love that show. POV, Subaru and Korone have an off collab. I thought this was really funny. There's actually another post on the Hololive Reddit where it was literally like Fubuki doing like the Tobey Maguire glasses meme, you know, like you take it off and you see something and you put them on and you see a little bit clearer. So she like takes them off and it's like just Korone and Subaru, and then she puts them on and it's like me and Shuba here. By the way, this is not Subaru. People get that, you know, very much mixed up. This is a duck based on a true duck. All right. This is not actually Subaru. As you can see, red hat instead of a multicolored hat with blue and white and stuff like that. This is her own duck. Right? This is Shuba, not Suba. Sometimes it takes a man to be best girl. Giguk. Ah, Lord Giguk, the master of quotes. Shoutouts to Giguk. I guess some people were actually wondering who I was and what my channel was about, and this is a pretty good comment that actually sums it up. Oh, it's great. I think he used to do mostly gaming content, especially fighting games, but it's really interesting to see him get more and more into VTubers over the past year. He does a lot of reacting to fan-submitted clips and famously even made an appearance to Asakoko. Yep, I did. That was crazy. You guys probably already know about that, but looking back at it, it still kind of baffles my mind. It's fun because a friend of mine, very into the FGC, watched Ko, and I found it odd his content has so many VTuber references. I said that I found him because of VTuber stuff and found it odd that he had FGC content. We both agree he's a great dude to watch, and I came in for the waifus but stayed for the fighting games. That's actually pretty cool, man. I like that. That's a cool story. To have a friend that actually knows me from like fighting game content and then you know me from VTuber stuff, and you kind of like intertwine together in some weird like fusion dance, and I don't know. It's just a cool story. That was cool. Hey, GG's. GG's. COVID is to thank for the shift, as it did a nasty number on the anime FGC scene, which Ko is a part of. VTubers filled the void. Yeah, I haven't really talked about this that much on the YouTube channel. I've talked about it plenty of times on Twitch. But yeah, essentially, and it wasn't just the anime FGC scene. It was just the FGC, the fighting game community in general, because most of the fighting games that were being played were primarily, ideally, and optimally played offline. And because of the whole COVID pandemic thing, we couldn't really do that. And you have to shift to this online environment, which fighting games are not optimized to do. There are some fighting games that are moving into the right direction, but during the start of the pandemic, everything was just so bad when it comes to online fighting games. It was so bad. I was just not wanting to play them anymore, and all of a sudden VTuber showed up and kind of like filled that void, like this person said. But yeah, pretty interesting comment. I do like to talk about this because it's a pretty interesting mentality to have, looking back at it, at what happened to the fighting game community while we were transitioning to an online environment. Did he lose a bet or something? I thought he said before he won't cosplay Korone, even though he has had that headwear and general look long before Korone's new outfit reveal. He just took it to the next level. No, I did not lose a bet. Like I mentioned before, basically I had a sub goal implemented for my chat and they were able to make it. When he fell down the rabbit hole, he hit every single root and hit the ground hard. Yeah, dude, tell me about it. My ass still kind of hurts. Ko is a respectable member of the community. Thanks, friend. I appreciate that. Please get him and Connor cosplaying Iron Mouse together in one stream. That'll be hilarious. I don't know about that. His cosplay of Iron Mouse is pretty freaking great. It was pretty legendary. Yeah. Connor's a cool guy. But hey, Connor, if you ever want to cosplay together, hit me up. This is kind of a thread. Somebody said who? And then my YouTube channel. And then an anime YouTuber, pretty popular one. pretty interesting. I think people, if they don't really see my channel and don't really watch my content on the outside, they would think I'm an anime YouTuber, but I'm not. I don't do that. I just react to VTubers. It's about as anime as I get, really. I play mostly anime fighting games. I do game highlights, and I do reactions of different things as well. Another weird, goofy content like that. I like being kind of a variety content creator. I like the effort, but is that fake Corona merch? It's written Corona. No, that is not fake Corona merch. That is custom-made, handmade stuff. My girlfriend Faith was actually extremely creative when it comes to, you know, making things with cloth and just knitting and sewing and doing all sorts of things with cloth. So she was able to make that cool doggo belt and have Corona on the other side, which the original Corona doesn't actually have, but I put it on there just as a little cool, cute thing. She also did like the shirt with all the different imprints of the Yubis and the dogs and the treats and the bones and stuff like that. It was pretty cool. She did a great job. And then somebody said here that there's actually Corona merch. I did not know there was Corona merch. That's crazy. That's awesome. This dude must love all the free advertisement he's getting. Well, that's not my intention. I just wanted to do something cool and interesting and entertaining. So, such is the power of sharing with your friends. This man is literally part of the community now, a good one at that. I take him over some I've seen. So we're going to start posting every YouTuber who's a fan of Hololive here. Lol. Yes, because the sub is here to talk about Hololive things, and he talks about Hololive things. I mean, yeah, I agree with this person. This is the Hololive Reddit, you know? If you see Gordon Ramsay talking about Hachima's cooking, for example, just hypothetically speaking, you're going to go to the Hololive Reddit. You're going to see memes pop out everywhere. You're going to see, oh my God, Gordon Ramsay commented on Hachima's cooking and such. Of course, people are going to be sharing that. I just don't get why he's mad about people posting Hololive related stuff in the Hololive Reddit. Not like this is Wall Street Bets or anything. Dude's been here ever since his debut on Asakoko, and he's probably in the hole a lot longer than the majority of the sub. Nah, he got sucked in before he showed up on Asakoko. Looking at this post, man, just made me realize like how old I feel now. Right? I've been in this hole for like over a year. It's crazy. Some people are just starting to be fans of the Hololive crew or just VTubers in general. Like some people started with Gura, some people started with Botan, some people started with Polka and stuff. Like I was there way before any of them even dreamed about a million subs. I remember when Corona had like 170K. Now that's nuts. Cursed. Ha ha ha. Cursed. I agree. Cursed. Hella cursed. Fucking cringe. I mean, yeah, pretty much, but it's fun. You know, I'd rather have fun and be cringe than be sad and depressed and lonely and think everything is just black and white. Wonder if this guy likes watching paint dry. I mean, that's like probably the only non-cringe content that I could possibly think of. I wonder if he eats his toast with no butter and without it being toasted. I wonder if he goes to Taco Bell and calls it authentic Mexican food. I wonder if he eats burgers with a sandwich bun. I wonder if he thinks penguins can fly. Anyways, yeah, pretty cringy. I agree. As someone who's been in the FGC for forever and semi-recently got into Hololive, I personally can't stand him. He seems like a decent guy, but he overreacts to everything. Everyone has their preferences, though. Just saying, you might not like it if you don't like reaction content. This one's pretty interesting. No, I pretty much agree. If you don't like reaction content, you're probably not going to like my content. That's just simple matter of the fact, right? I try to mix up as much of other content as I can. He seems like a decent guy, but he overreacts to everything. I will say this. I do tend to get extremely excited over certain things, so I definitely agree on like reacting more than I should, but that's because I can't help it. But I'm gonna tell you right now, I do not go in with an agenda and be like, you better get overly excited, you better sell it to the camera, you better go bananas, you better go crazy, let's go, make some noise. Just try to be as artificial as you can with your reaction. Everything I do comes from inside, and it comes out how it wants to come out, okay? I had to control it sometimes, but for the most part, sometimes when I go crazy, that's how it is. A lot of my BB tag reactions for the character reveals were like that. A lot of my BBCF stuff was like that. And other reactions to fighting game content and to just the content that I do right now in general. I don't go in with an agenda of overreacting. It's just how my body reacts to said thing. I personally can't stand them. Whew! Damn, dude. I wonder if we would ever meet in an event. Would it be better if I was sitting down? Anyways, no, it was just a joke. Thank you for your comment. It's true. Like, sometimes overreacting happens a lot in the community, and I can see where you're coming from. and stuff. And if you don't like reaction content, yeah, just I don't think I would recommend my content to you. That's pretty much all the comments that I wanted to go through. They're pretty interesting. I do like going through Reddit comments. Some of them are really, really funny, and some of them are really good. When it comes to this, I appreciate all the love and all the support that that you guys gave to that Reddit post, or just to the cosplay in general. It was pretty surreal to see Korone, Fubuki, the Reddit, everybody just have such outstanding amount of support for the actual cosplay itself. It makes me want to do another one, but who knows what it's going to be. Anyways, thank you all for watching this video. Thank you all for hanging out with me. Thank you for supporting the channel. Of course, uploads will be starting up regularly again. I've been thinking about starting to make some off-stream YouTube videos, so I'll definitely be back with another off-stream YouTube video strictly for the YouTube crew. So tune in for that, and yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much.